Yeah, and I really want to see how well C9 can use the pick potential of the Trundle and the Ashe to focus towards Jensen's lane even more so, because if Bjergsen gets going on Vladimir, we've seen Pobelta, we've seen in the European finals, Vladimir's have been getting absolutely out of control.
Blue buff, one of the advantages of having Rek'Sai.
And it was a
he might get him. He won't quite die to the poison, I don't think. Oh, he got him! Oh, he burns down!
Here he is.
Here comes the attempt. It's going to get the knock back in. A lot of damage. Jensen flashed away. He's running for dear life with the ghost and can turn it back around on Bjergsen. Decent damage. And now Meteos in the fray as well. 2-on-2. Shenaldi comes in and suddenly TSM in a 2v3. They don't like this one. The flash. Oh, he doesn't quite land it, but the arrow from downtown. Sneaky secures it. However, the trade kill comes back through. Nicely done by Bjergsen picking up Jensen.
Fights are happening.
Tron Hawks is in a bad spot, but also a nice fight in the bot lane. The pillar catches Biofrost, who doesn't have a way out and just dies. Doesn't even pop the gray health. And now Doublet's in danger. He's gonna go down, a double kill for Sneaky.
Here comes Svenskeren and two more.
Here we go, the pillar and the exhaust. Sneaky gets the Shenaldi. Here comes the body slam. Could be an easy explosive cast. Knocks him back in. Bad days ahead for Sneaky. One kill. The root and the smoothie could make it a second, but Impact here to hold him up for a little bit longer. Flashes away, stays alive. Just the one for zero, but still advantage TSM.
Bjergsen's coming in.
Flanking under the turret pillar to keep him away.
How much does he want this dive?
They want the first blood turret gold, I think. I think they're just going to try to zone them off.
Every one of TSM is down in this lane, and C9 be a bit foolish to
Jensen's
defend,
but two.
Jensen finally showing up. It's a 4-on-5. The root onto Impact, half HP onto Shen. Barrow does a bit more damage, but now, yes, Bjergsen having to, Hanser, watch out, taking a lot of damage, the flash knockup. Bit out more than he can chew, but Biofrost takes a bite out of crime and takes him back
here
out.
They go.
They re-engage. The snipes had a doublet. It's going to be a shared tank, and Smoothie eats the last bullet, and C9 able to just barely walk away with their lives.
This is where TSM has been able to excel for most of it, but Doublet just recalled to finish his Duskblade, and they're probably losing this Drake.
He's not at the right time, and the Drake does go down. Svenskeren down to half as well. Pillar helps with that, but
arrow
is in this one, but a nice chomp by a Biofrost. Yeah, what's Ash gonna do when I eat your prey away? But now here comes the attempt on a
turn.
A lot of hits come through. Shenaldi to join this one. Stan United gonna be there, and here's the 5-on-5. Bjergsen exhausted, has to kite away. Maybe there's gonna be a bit of a re-engage as the dancing grenade comes through, hits a few members of C9. A taunt comes back in, looking for damage on a Biofrost, pops the gray health. Impact's gonna take the Duskblade. He's gonna be all right with this one. Svenskeren now low, under 1,000. Smoothie, dangerous as well. The flash in, but he hits the wrong target. Double it, does not click the right champion. Could have gotten a kill instead. They all walk away, only the Drake losing its life. But now suddenly Hanser back in this one on the front line.
He's all alone.
He's out of health. Oath back in. He can't quite kill off Smoothie. And another huge mistake, TSM overstepping. As he looks to make this comeback happen and gain an ult.
He's opening up.
Gonna hit Smoothie, slow down. There's a nice body slam in. Looks for Jensen, but the explosive cast has not put him into the team. So far, so good for Cassiopeia. Flashes out, stays alive, dodges the snipe, and the fight is in. Sneaky with the Hurricane looking for damage. There's a flash knockup. They're gonna go for Biofrost. That will be TSM's Canadian support going down. They find one. They're looking for two. Bjergsen's caught up. There's two for C9. 7-2 on the scoreboard right now, looking towards Baron.
Prince would be.
Jensen even has enough mana, or money, I should say, to finish his Archangel staff.
Ben's caught!
Yeah, and because Svenskeren's caught, the flash into Devour. Biofrost keeps him safe for now. Bjergsen exhausted, running away for dear life, but Sven still burns down the poison.
Beautiful
just
pillar!
Too much for him. Pillar
to buy
a bit of time.
In.
Huge knockups, and here comes the backline access. C9 have already picked up one, but how many more can they really get? The snipe comes through. Meteos takes him out, and it's going to be a whitewash. No one from TSM can stand up to the damage output.
That should be a bit of a duel, and actually, TSM's going for the fight right now. Teleport behind C9.
They need to block for Sneaky.
Okay, takes one shot, gets the shield. That'll probably time out without doing much more. Svenskeren on the side. Hanser there as well. Looks for Jensen. He's got onto the back line, and it's going to be the attempt to peel. Here comes Bjergsen in as well. Svenskeren gets out. They picked off one of the carries. Now it's just up to Jensen, and he's got Bjergsen on top of him. He's trying to take him out to save this fight. A quick Zonya's bot, then double it, picks up Smoothie. It's two already for TSM, but Bjergsen running down. He will bleed out, and that's not a good thing for TSM. Hanser's next. Impact is there with a killing spree because they kept Jensen alive. The knock up here, and it's going to be another kill picked up, and now it's Doublelift alone running back into his base. He gets some support back from Svenskeren, but it's still enough damage. They finally do take out Jensen. Then overall, it's a 3-for-2 slight
Impact
lead.
Wants
and
it.
It's there, the battle. On top of the inhibitor, two tanks facing the tank and the AD carry. And take it back, three kills on punishment. With this dragon up, we'll see if C9 can grab it.
C9 He still doesn't have flash, but it's almost up, and that will be critical for next fight. Biofrost gets hacked!
And no one can save the Tahm Kench. He's gonna take a lot of damage. Pillar in the back line. Meteos knocked around. Impact in the front as well. But here comes Hanzo looking for sneaky in the right-hand side as Biofrost gets whittled down as well. Hanzo pops the ulti, gets back, stays alive, jumps forward, running out of HP, and suddenly will get taken out. Jensen gets the poison onto him. This time, finally, they do pick off Bjergsen, and that is the mid laner gone. A 2-0. C9 with complete map control now as Biofrost looks to snipe one in the back, and he pops the Guardian Angel off of Meteos. Fourth shot a little too early. I'm not sure if it would have killed him, but it would have been close. He's still 20 seconds on the solo laners of TSM. Cloud9 gonna go for Nexus turrets here. They don't want a dragon. They want game one right now on the Nexus turret number one. Three
going
versus
down
five.
Fast.
Damage on a sneaky
double
out. Drake certainly helps. Turret number two. 5 seconds on Hanzo. Here comes the engage and just barely double it stays alive. But look at the damage up.
Hanzo
picked up Tahm Kench. Here comes Hanzo. Nexus turret still alive. Damage on
right
a smoothie. They've already picked up three, and suddenly C9 taking a little bit too slowly. Smoothie burning down. Hanzo stays alive as well. Merlin Omicron helping certainly a little bit here. It's a 5-2. The solo's trying to keep it up. Bjergsen burning down. He's going to lose his life.
That's
on
it!
The next as they go, and game one goes to Cloud9.
Abyssal Scepter will benefit him. So that is the counterpick value that they're able to get. So yes, TSM does deny him Cassiopeia, but they also pick him into one of the more favorable matchups.
Early base and a TP back to
there's the gank.
There's the gank.
First knockup flash comes in. Jensen flashes the follow, but here comes the re-engage. The burn down, the poison. It's going to take him out. And a first blood comes through.
Right now it's Smoothie getting rid of the ward.
Here they comes Svenskeren. This could be a fight. The support's very low on health. Smoothie's got to run back, and a great flash by Devil gets away from Enchanted Crystal Arrow, and Svenskeren knocked into Smoothie,
in.
And here comes the teleport. Hanzo's part of this engagement, and Sneaky's getting low. He flashes to stay alive. Impacts in the tray as well, and suddenly Sven's out of health. There's the first kill coming through. Suddenly, it's going to be a lot of kills coming through, but here comes the re-engage. They've found one, and no more snipes come through for Double If. However, it's still plus one.
Yes, he's 1-0-1. He's definitely off to a pretty good start this time. Ooh, they're looking for Impact.
Flash chase, 3v1. Impact in a bad spot, but he's Meganar, hops around, gets rooted up, a big stun comes through. Meanwhile, Jensen in a bad spot against Bjergsen. The first kill happens in mid lane, and the solo kill. Look at that, another two for TSM.
Changed since 15, but TSM making an aggressive move towards the Baron.
They finally got the vision where they wanted it, and his Baron is dropping rapidly. Double Inferno Drake helps a little bit, but a lot of AoE
they're
come
going
across.
For the fight.
Svenskeren's low, so it's Biofrost.
Damage.
And this is going to be Jensen fairly safe, but look out, because here comes the dive. It's a bunch of damage from Hanzo. Dodges the knockup. Here comes Curtain Call, and Hanzo gets the assassination. Biofrost low, but the support tank taking all the damage seems fine for TSM. Impact running for his life. Snipe not quite going to land on him. Biofrost gets the kill onto Smoothie. Subportal combat successful.
Had to get healed. Had to get that movement speed to get out. But C9 looking to chase down for kills.
The battle. Impact in the front line stunned up several times in a row. He needs Meganar. He's not got it. He's going to get chopped up, and Double If is on a killing spree. Hanzo's still on the chase. Ult's back. He's totally fine. And no one's really going to die to the life destruction ray.
They
now
low,
the
though.
Curtain Call looking for a little bit more. Smoothie to take a couple bullets, but one more might kill him. And it does. 936 knocks him out.
And so clean. But even then, they're pretty low. They just have that one Mountain Drake, and C9 want to stop it.
Hanzo's flanking.
Well, it's going to be Meteos looking for the smite steal. He's trying to try. He's close. 9,000, not going to happen. 900, I should say. And another Baron Nashor secured now for TSM. Jensen, nice kite away from the chair, but it's not enough for him. Hanzo's in range. Wasn't able to be stopped. Astro hits the front line. Here comes quite a damage output. Gets stunned up, though. That was Hanzo's doing. And it's going to be Jensen forced to run away. Quick. Ulti back to stay alive, a knock around. It's Hanzo dueling up with Impact, and it's going to be a lot of damage back and forth. Nearly kills out the Ica, but he won't quite get him. Now it's Biofrost the front line, double free engage. It gets stunned up, though. That's a big deal. They get rid of the AD carry, and one of TSM's three threats is gone. Svenskeren tunnels over the wall, has to flash out. There could be more happening. Hotshot sees the team, and it's going to be, wow, the Deathfire touch of Double If takes down Impact. Hanzo was able to recall and teleport in. He's got the shield. He's got the chase down. There's the debilitating poison. Double If, oh, almost drops out. I take it back. It was Biofrost who died, not Double Lift.
Flash, and that fight was incredible. He flashes over the wall for that Gnarled. That was so good.
We just talked about the way they win is if they get a Gnarled, and a Double Lift knocks it away. TSM wants to continue this push, but have they overstayed their welcome?
Ooh, you gotta watch out for the poison. Hanzo back in as well. He wants Sneaky. It's gonna be the first kill picked up, and he will knock it away as Double Lift shuts him down from long range. You've still got four alive for TSM as Biofrost runs down the map.
C9 needs to take this risk to try to do it. They're falling too far behind. They can't afford to give it over.
Meteos would have an angle to try a steal. and it's all about the Velcro's ultimate. Hanzo, there's the zone. Here's the fight. Meteor's getting close.
Smoothie's already dead. There's the first kill. It's TSM playing it right. They're doing the dragon bait. They know Cena has to take the risk. They know they've got to show up for this fight, so they peel off at half health, going for the kill. One already gone, looking for a second. Hanzo nearly in range of impact, but can't quite land the slow, and that means C9 just running into their base, but Jensen can't run fast enough. The tentacles don't get him out there. So now, 5 versus 3, Hanzo looking for another, pushing the wave in, and impact can't quite stop at all, it looks like.
And this could actually be the final push. They've been able to kill enough people. They're keeping impact away from the base. It's a two-man defense attempt here for C9.
4v2 to close out the game. Meteos rooted up. Guardian Angel gonna go down. He's been dropped already. Here comes the final Nexus turret. Here comes the series tie-in game win. Bjergsen tanks the arrow. Double lift is legendary on this Jhin. When he got killed in lane last time, he's the carry in this one. And game two goes to TSM.
To be fair, it's a big change for Cloud9. We have not seen Zach in a long time, and I, for one, am super hyped.
Yeah, just thinking about the early game, I think it's going to be so critical. He's actually going for a gank in the top lane, so Meteos could be getting the red, but this gank, Impact, going to be tough to outplay this.
You wouldn't really expect him to be top this at this exact timing, but Impact running out of health. There's a flash knockup, and he can't get over the wall. First blood goes for the Svenskeren. Here's Meteos coming up, sensing blood in the water.
Yeah, double Doran's Blade Gnar is such an aggressive pick. Meteos popping up. He's going to get spotted. Hanzo has no flash. Can he get away?
First Hyper, shield coming out.
Here
3 second countdown. Knockup is there, and they've got the damage. Top lane counter kill, and Hanzo has no way to rejoin the lane.
Lane like this one, he doesn't have to go in the river. He can actually gank from above it. He's
and
got
he's
him.
Got a Bjergsen. There's the knockback. The chain of ultimates. There's no chance at all. Carry in game two. Hanzo's now being held down.
Meteos has no great buff, and he's looking.
Goes for to land the knockup. Flashes to knock him back in, though, and it's going to be dangerous. They're trading close back and forth. And Svenskeren doing what he can to make it all happen. The poison, the heal. Meteos splits into four. Jensen still chasing, but doesn't have the damage. And that's going to be two kills, you assume, coming in for TSM as Meteos will lose his life. Hanzo gets a kill.
Into five more CS. Maybe he doesn't finish a void.
Oh, double lift.
Double lift flashes on.
Maybe he dies.
Knock back around. Arrow's going to land on Biofrost. That should be a kill onto the Bard. Flashes into the Magical Journey.
Too deep.
Meteos chases too deep. He's going to get split up into four. And yeah, that's Meteos getting quartered. Now, can the team regroup in time? The teleport to keep the Bloblet alive. It doesn't take damage. Here comes Impact. Meteos jumps over the wall, but into Bjergsen's waiting arms, and another kill comes through. That's going to feel good for TSM, and even more insults. Snipes on a Smoothie, losing health, has to flash away from the tempered fate of Bar.
And couldn't get it.
And you could see that Sneaky was considering following through on that one as well, but decided not to. Hanzo, though, could get double kill.
Hanzo does not have the ult he used to get back in a lane. One more hit, he'll do it, and Impact gets the damage he needs. He'll survive this turret shot, and he's going to recall if no one shows up to kill him. Zach's go Runic Echoes and use that as... Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Impact again, just finding the solo kill. Hanzo didn't even get to cast the ultimate. He had it up, and it didn't happen.
Bjergsen's coming in, though.
Well, the hop came in time, and it bounced off of a minion, so Impact has a lot of time to buy. Teleport, it's going
to
be close. Can Svenskeren get the knockup?
He's...
Okay. Force a couple summoners out, but Impact is now in a bad spot. He's going to get chained down. The kill comes through with the assist. For this fight, TSM have 5 up here, 5v4. Yeah. C9 cannot choose to defend this one.
Run.
A root on Meteos. There's a stun out from Bard. Here comes the Hanzo parallel convergence. Meteos ults, he's running as fast as he can, but split into four one more time.
The best thing I could hope for is the turret trade.
They're going to knock him down. Meteos will lose his life. How much more is going to happen? Snipes aren't going to land. Bjergsen down to half HP.
Hanzo, he could go down and likely go a big fight here.
Going for the battle. Knock up on a Meteos. Zach has to flash away in a two-man tempered fate. It caught the back line. Here comes the dive. Svenskeren finding a little bit. Meteos separates the team, but he's running out of health. Here comes the disintegration ray. Nearly does knock down Svenskeren. Ash gets the damage across, but Hanzo managed to get the trade kill on the jungler. Now he's in the back line. Pops through the exhaust. Kills off Sneaky. And Smoothie himself running low on HP. He's got to run from this one. No slow is going to land for Jensen. Couple more hits will do it. Here comes Impact on the side, but gets sniped out. And Bjergsen gets the fourth kill of the fight. Only Jensen survives it. I mean, enough. Only one level now. And suddenly there's reinforcements. Impact's running out of health. He's Meganar, but doesn't even matter. Svenskeren's there to make it all happen. And the kill comes through for Hanzo getting revenge on his lane opponent. Tempered Fate hits Smoothie. That's going to be a blended trundle. Double kill so far for Hanzo. Smite. Not quite going to land, but throw it down.
And
Arrow's going to hit.
Going, desperation.
Yes, they catch up. Double lift. But into the back line they go. A double already for Bjergsen. He's going to run everybody down. No one's left alive. It's the split of the blobs. And that's going to be Meteos completing the ace for TSM. Fast one, the fastest of the series. Second Nexus turret is down. There's not enough respawns in time. TSM gonna take the lead in the series. And they are one game away from their fourth North American championship.
In dichotomy, Doublelift gets his pocket pick.
Yeah, he really loves playing Lucian. He played it so much during the regular season, and it makes sense in this context. If he was playing Ashe, he's a little bit more of a sitting duck if they do get in a situation where...
He might get a conversion on right now.
Running up onto this one, trying to figure out where
it's because they
are.
Know the strat from Talia.
He's
going
to go
Raptor.
Pick the first camp. Has a flash wave, but that means body slam is easy. And Svenskeren metagames the obvious Talia laning phase. It's the easy chase down. Nowhere to go. First blood.
Early lane shove to get pressure elsewhere. But if they can get one back right here, double
it. Here comes Meteos. Flash knock. If they're going to trigger the stun as well, is it enough damage? Yes, it is. Sneaky. Crucially gets the kill.
Make it up that way. Because the more they can keep on to route, the safer their bottom lane will be.
Dodge zone is down, Meganar used, and look at the low health bars here on a Haunter.
Flash
is gonna come in. That's enough damage. Go to the source of the global, and he's been shut down.
But if it's a steady state game, I expect that top turret to go down.
See if a steady state can happen, then C9 with
Jesse has a flash.
There's the body slam and a flash of the knockback. Doesn't quite get him far enough, but it's still gonna be enough damage. A nice pickup once again. Bjergsen 2-0.
From one and there's no flash for the other.
They see Gragas, that means they might try the dive.
And here comes the attempt, there's the jump on in, a lot of knockups, and here comes the Hansa ulti. One more shot, won't quite get the kill, and now Meteos is in danger. Can he get out? No, he didn't have the tunnel.
They really weren't that close to that kill. Now a 2-0 Bjergsen.
Yeah, Meteos gotta be careful.
Ben has all.
Wow, a big knockback by Svenskeren into the engage. Hemo Plague is on, good damage on Meteos. Running out of health pretty rapidly. One more hit'll do it. Does he have the reinforcements? Juke it as long as he can, but that will be a kill picked up. Bjergsen gets it, 3-0 now for him. Doublelift going for the chase. Sneaky's gotta be careful. Juke left right, but that's gonna put him in range of a pillar. Where does he even go from here? Shadow coming across. One more hit'll do it. He's ticking down and Doublelift.
What's it?
One dash will kill him. He comes in under the turret and gets that kill picked up. Bad news bears for C9's bot lane. They're down one. Meteos also caught out. It's going from bad to worse. They're going to lose two. TSM up now 6-2 in kills. And C9 still trying to fight, but it's a 3v5. They can't really get much. And ooh. A few attacks will do it. And here comes Jensen to kind of cement that even happens right there. Puts the wall down, looks for damage on Haunter. And actually, Shen's going to have to respect this kind of damage output. Here comes Impact. And actually, they get the kill.
Bit that a little bit, but there's a fight breaking out.
Meteos. Begins. Meteos, Guardian Angel in the front line, taking out of health. And he's going to pop the GA. Svenskeren a bit low, but not low enough. Staying alive. Flash that with his life. And Meteos still at the chase. And one more pillar, one more shot. Doublelift takes him down. Now into the back line. Haunter dodging what he can, but Impact is certainly scary. Flash for the chase. A snipe from Sneaky. And now Bjergsen getting chain CC. The pool is on cooldown. A few more hits will do it. The house comes down and a shutdown is in.
Doublelift is super low.
Very, very low. One more clock tower goes in. The summoner heal keeps him alive. Biofrost runs away. Baron Nashor
waiting for the collapse.
They hit Biofrost.
They got him.
That's one kill so far. Bjergsen still waiting for someone to jump in a little bit too far, but now they see where he's there. The curtain call comes in and the bot lane, a turret fell down somewhere.
Do have the
Gnar has TP.
And Weaver's wall still up. They can completely cut them off. Here comes the play. Meteos has Guardian Angel, finds the front line. The knockback comes in. Doublelift gets the ulti in. Here comes the battle. Smoothie has to kite back. Shield is on. Sven's going to lose his Guardian Angel as well. And here comes the revive from Meteos. He's going to go down. Bjergsen down to half. Here comes the battle back as Sven's going to lose his life. Both junglers now dead. 4v3, but Smoothie's injured. They've got to be careful. Doublelift can clean it up. Here comes the damage shot, but Smoothie's going to go down. Haunter staying alive.
No!
The Meganar hits up the impact. And he's gonna use the Zonias. Now what's left for him? Jensen gets him! It's an ace for Cloud9! Gonna go over, spoof! Meteos gets redemption, he lands the smite, he has
lost once more!
So many buffs this game, so many camps at Svenskeren, and when it mattered most in game four, Meteos lands the smite. They get the last hit.
Back and forth, Hemo Plague ends. C9's still alive, but they've got to limp out of this one. Root's going to land on Biofrost. Once more, the engage and an impact.
Haunter's behind them!
Low, looking for the play. A taunt coming across. Puts the dodge zone in as well. Smoothie running out of HP. He's nearly dead. And Bjergsen gets one. The stun's not going to land. He popped the Zonias. C9 running out of health. They've got to run away from this one. Impact is nearly dead.
Elder going to be on the table soon.
For the play again,
one step on a couple
of impact on the front line. Here comes Smoothie going for the knock. If they might catch in, yes, they do. Biofrost is down. Smoothie's gonna trade his life as well, though. 4v4, no supports alive. No Guardian Angel for Meteos, whereas TSM still have two. two.
The Weaver's Wall!
Weaver's Wall catches off a couple. Now can they have the follow-up damage? A couple of stuns come in. They've got Bjergsen, and they shut him down with a 1600 damage crit.
Can they get double?
Low. Meteos, another knock of trades his life, but it does.
Double lift!
Gets the GA.
Double killing them all!
Kills everybody! They've got three. Impact goes down, and ace for TSL! Time. It's Invasion of Wards, but who
they
cares?
They want to force it.
C9 gonna have a hell of a time fighting him. Curtain call pops, and they're gonna go for this play. Weaver's Wall
they're
puts
actually
him off the
fighting.
Thing, and there's a knockback. They've caught Impact, but he's Meganar, and he can't do it in time. The first kill comes in for TSM, and this could be the championship team fight. Here they go. A double already for Bjergsen into the back line. They're killing everybody. C9 only have two members remaining. Make that one. Here we go. The ceremonial taking of the Nexus turrets. Nothing to stand in their way as TSM cement themselves as the most dominant organization in North American League of Legends and win their fourth North American championship.
An incredible moment for these guys. You can see just how much it means to them. Disappointment last year in Vegas, and now finally victory is theirs.
And the fourth game was the closest of all of them. They really had to fight for that last game. If you're looking at Cloud9 right now, you can see the disappointment because they know they had some chances in that fourth game to force a game five. And now if they want to go to Worlds, they have to make it through the regional qualifier.
Yeah, now it's either C9 or Immortals. Maybe it's Liquid, maybe it's Envy, but those are the two you look at. And yes, TSM can rightly hoist that trophy as the top dogs of North America. Rookie Biofrost in his hometown in his first split says, I'm the best.
It's gotta feel amazing for Biofrost, and it might even feel better for the other four players on TSM who were one team fight away of hoisting that trophy in the spring, but now it's theirs in four games.